Last week we went to a music festival. Sunny weather, great music, dancing and having a good time with friends. And lots of other people, as you can see. But of course, as always, I kept my eyes open for video ideas and clothing patterns caught my eye. Let me show you why I love to look at them. Hi there, my name is Albert van der Zwart. Welcome to Imperfect Paintings, inspiring you to embrace the magic of making art. First a reminder. I saw several polka dot patterns as well. In case you want to participate in the currently running painting challenge, link up here. I already received some nice artwork in my mailbox. Here the first pattern on this lady's shirt. Just some messy brush strokes. A white sheet, a 40mm brush, and here I go. Oh wow, a great start. I just continue painting and I notice my brush still has paint, even after making a number of brush strokes. But the shirt was black with white brush strokes, so I paint the whole sheet black. And clean my table, what also can be fun. When dry, I take white paint. But before the first brush stroke, I get rid of some of the paint on my brush. On the first sheet, I was painting within the boundaries of the paper. Right away, on this sheet, I deliberately try to paint beyond the edges, as if my painting is bigger than the sheet. To me, this way of working adds a more spacious feeling to it. A few quick changes with an 80mm brush to add an unexpected extra in this 40mm brush stroke world. When playing like this, do know you have options. Let me show. First a normal brush stroke. Now I lift one side of the brush to create a different looking line. Here I turn the brush from wide to small and back again. Now three brush strokes in line. When I go back to the original pattern, I see it only looked like identical brush strokes. When looking closer, I now see it shows all sorts of variations. This is what I mean by seeing what you look at. When I put my paintings side by side, I notice the darker spots in the first one. They add a focus point. Question is, do I miss a detail like this in the second one? Over to a blurred, unsharp picture. I see white spots on a black background. Looks simple, right? It may seem ridiculous to look or try to paint one. But when I give it a try, I discover it's all about composition. Which part of the paper will I fill and which part do I leave open? Do I want groups? How many? How big? And where do I place them? What to do with the corners and the edges of my sheet? Rather basic, simple questions when painting abstract like this. They almost seem irrelevant. But when I put these three together, I guess everyone can see the difference and which one looks more interesting. Back to the original, and this time it looks like I painted something similar looking. I accidentally found an interesting one at home. I took a picture of this skirt, but now I spot this section. Interesting, and bubble wrap comes to mind. I always have several pieces available and cut four pieces for four sheets. Now it's a matter of painting white paint for an interesting print. It's not complicated. I use a 10mm brush and paint parts with white before I print. And of course, it's a mirrored version of what I painted. I make another one using an 80mm brush. Now let's put the two next to each other. Amazing, in my opinion. I make two extra ones. It's fun to play like this, because it challenged me to create different looking ones. Again, it's about where to paint and where not. Just playing with black and white is almost always a success. My advice, create a little stash of bubble wrap pieces for you never know when. Here I put the four together, and by changing the positions, I can create another overview. I love it. Of course, I can also use a smaller piece of bubble wrap to play with. And just by moving it around, I already get an idea of my options. Now some paint on it and magic happens within seconds. Looking at the picture and after making my version, I get a better idea of composition and it can also help me to train my eye for detail. Now over to the skirt on the right of the same picture. I take a 50 by 50 centimeter piece of paper. Different sizes and different types of paper can give different results. Try this next time, in case you are not used to switching already. I take some India ink and try pouring it on the sheet, but I guess it's too old and got thicker. Working with it is also hard. That could be an asset when painting about a difficult subject, but in this case of fun and frivolous festival painting, it has a bad influence on my flow and mood. So I add some Ecoline liquid watercolor to the bowl. This helps. Now I can focus on creating a pattern. In my mind, the pattern resembles the ones on pieces of plywood, or like certain wild animals carry around. I also realize I often see it, but never really looked, studied or analyzed the pattern really well, and slow down again, now hesitating how to proceed. Running into trouble like this can be just as entertaining or educational. I take the squeeze bottle again and it feels as if, by adding the watercolor, I liberate my playfulness again. Having fun is, in my opinion, essential in creating. When playing, taking it all not that seriously, I also don't care less if what I make looks like the picture. The watercolor flows and I just follow along. When dry, I notice in the beginning, I try to create a pattern. But the picture I started with is just an idea. Deviating in the process is also okay, so I just mess around. And when finished, I notice that the part where I started definitely looks different from the rest. Not better, not worse, just different. In this one, I see light strips on a dark background. The strips look random, but how to get to the irregular shapes they have? First, I create a black painted sheet. I could use black paper, but my painted sheet is a bit shiny, with nuances, and I prefer this over the perfectly made matte black paper. When dry, I cut the sheet in two and one half into roughly 10 by 15 centimeter pieces. I take one of the 10 by 15 centimeter ones and tear it into strips. I also tear two sheets at the same time. I can tear in a million different ways, but this time I just want not perfect strips. Now it's a matter of putting them on the black sheet. Without much thought, I take the pieces and put them down. Not thinking is an interesting technique because it can show, logically, duh, what will happen when I don't think. What I now have here looks very regular, smaller pieces in two rows and not that interesting. On the other end of the sheet, it looks irregular and way more interesting. I start again and this time I put the pieces in line with the length of the sheet. This looks quite different. I don't know about you, but I notice I really love all these tiny little pieces mixed with the bigger ones. Now let's try the negative version of it. At first I try to put them down in an interesting way, but towards the end I don't even look at the paper anymore. The fun of not looking is that random can play along. I love random, because it works its own magic. Pieces overlap, pieces are partly outside the paper, pieces are upside down and, because of the black paint, the small white tear edges play along. The smudgy border adds a nice touch as well. Knowing what to do can be just as interesting as knowing when to let go. One more example of random. Now I take all my pieces, hover a second, and let them find their place. Don't you just love this? In case you like to see playful, inspired art, just click on the link and I will see you over there in the next video. Thanks for watching and have a wonderful day.